Greetings and hello, amazing people. This is how dedicated I am to you guys. Just came home from work, got something to eat, was reading some comments on my way to take a fucking shower. And I was like, hey, let's read some comments and see what's going on. And then I went down a rabbit hole. I answered some of the comments when I got home. Also, and we are kind of in a dilemma here, the same with Manjaro versus Arch Linux. People still don't understand that Ubuntu is not Debian. It's not Debian. It's not Debian. Just because it uses deb files and just because it's using the apt package format or package handler don't mean it's Debian. Just because it's built upon the Debian code don't mean it's Debian. Let me explain. Ubuntu is what you will call a fork. What is a fork? That is if someone takes a forking or copying a code and taking it in a new direction. You know, they're middling around with everything. A really, really good way to see if something is a fork and not is to see where do the repos come from. Ubuntu maintained their own repos. They did not have to do that if it was just a Debian distribution, because then they would be relying on the Debian repositories and then unmodified Debian packages. But because Ubuntu is not Debian, it's a fork of Debian, they have to maintain their own repositories. Why? Because they do so much middling and fiddling and poking and taking out and putting in and stuff like that to the Debian base that it becomes incompatible with Debian. That's why you can't take a repository that's made for Debian and use that under Ubuntu, and you can't take a repository or PPA that's meant for Ubuntu and use it under Debian. It may work once in a while, but at some point you will break your shit. That's the closest Ubuntu is to Debian. It's using deb files and it's using the apt package manager. Most people, when they look into a distribution, they just look at, oh, they are using the same extensions. Oh, they're using the same package manager, and then they draw the conclusion. It's not that simple. Let me explain really, really, really high level what Ubuntu is doing. So Ubuntu, every 6 months, I don't know if this is the case, but let's just pretend it is. It will make sense in the end anyway. They look at Debian. And they say, now we're going to make a new release of Ubuntu. So they take everything that's in the Debian repositories, freezing it. It's now ours. Or forking it over to their repos. And then they start to do the Ubuntu thing. They may start to modify the tlibc. They may start to modify xorg. They may start to modify the desktop environments. They may start to modify the Mesa libraries. They may start to modify other libraries to make it work better as intended with Ubuntu. And they are messing around with the core system, even systemd sometimes. Yes, they sometimes submit that back to Debian, but it takes time before landing Debian. So they mess around all over the place with Debian. They take something out there, put something in there, change something here and stuff like that. And the more they fiddle around with the code base that they forked, it become less and less Debian. That's how Ubuntu is made. Where if we take Mint, what they do is that they are basically just saying, oh, there's a new LTS release out. Let's plug on Cinnamon Desktop to that and some of their own software. They took away snap packages and added back some deb packages. So they do a little bit of fiddling around with it, but not much. And what that basically means is that the Cinnamon Mint portion of Mint and the Ubuntu portion of Mint is separate. They don't really speak with each other. Again, they do a little bit, but think about it like this is easier to understand. If you think about it as with Linux Mint, there is the Debian the Ubuntu portion, and there is the Mint portion. And the Mint portion, you know, the Cinnamon Desktop, the Mint tools, work independently from the Ubuntu portion. With the Ubuntu, there's no Debian portion. Because they forked Debian. They took what they need from Debian, and then they modified the living shit out of it. So yes, some things may work the same as under Ubuntu and Debian. They may do just like some things works the same as in Arch Linux as in Debian. There are some things that are universal the same on all distributions, no matter how they are built, because it's a fundamental standard within Linux, unofficial standard or what you will call it. So there are fundamental things that works the same, but there are so many things that don't work the same between Ubuntu and Arch. There are no Debian portion of Ubuntu. There's only Ubuntu. Where under Mint and Sorbian and Elementary OS, there is the Ubuntu part, the Mint part, the Ubuntu part, the Elementary OS part, the Ubuntu part, and the Sorbian part, and they are kind of not really, or they are, for all intents and purposes, independent of each other. So that's the difference between the respin. All of those you just talked about are respins because they take an existing distribution and slapping stuff on top of it. Where a fork take an existing distribution and they kick it and metal it and, you know, shop things out and do all kind of things to it so it's unrecognizable. A fun fact how you can actually think about this, OpenSUSE and SUSE way back in the 90s, you know, when most of you guys and girls was just seeming in your dad's little penis, was originally forked out of Slackware. And we all know today that OpenSUSE has nothing in common with Slackware. But OpenSUSE, or it was called SUSE back then, we only had SUSE back then, was not even a fork. It started out as a respin of Slackware. And then they started to modify more and more and more and more to the code base, so it became unrecognizable as Slackware. So now it's an independent distribution. Another distribution that started out like that is PC Linux OS. It started as a fork or a respin of, can't remember if it was Mantriq back then or Mantriva. And then over the years, it slowly got so distant from its parent distribution that it was forked on that it became incompatible with it and it became a dependent distribution. Solus, you all see that as an independent distribution. I think Solus actually came from Debian. But they modified so much to the first, like they started with a Debian base and then modified so much to it that it became unrecognizable as a Debian distribution. Just because some distributions are using the same tools, the same extensions, meaning package formats, and so on, don't mean that they are the same distribution. It's all about what's going on under the hood. The same with distributions. Yes, Ubuntu is heavily benefiting from Debian. Like I said, each 6 months, they freeze the Debian repositories and fork them and start to work on Ubuntu. And yes, if Debian went away, they would have a tough time. Let's not be wrong here. But they could still kind of easy continue just working on the existing code base. Because they already use their own kernel, they use their own libraries, they use their own modified desktop environments, and their own, you know, most of it is done with Ubuntu. It's, you know, is Ubuntu's own. So that basically just means that if Debian goes away, we can just then fork the previous version of Ubuntu. And yes, they have to do a little bit more work. Don't get me wrong, it will hurt them. But if Ubuntu goes away, Linux Mint will be nothing more than a desktop environment and some few software. If Ubuntu went away, Elementary OS would be nothing more than a desktop environment and some desktop software. Look at it in this way also. If all the Debian repositories went off the face of Earth tomorrow, you could still run Ubuntu. If all of the Ubuntu repositories got nuked and went away tomorrow, you could not run Sorbian, Mint, Elementary OS, Farin OS, or any other Ubuntu respin, because they get 99 or 95 or however whatever number you put in there, they get most of their software, most of their, you know, basically they get their operating system from Ubuntu. So it kind of irritates me a little bit that people that really really want to be knowledgeable within Linux, that they can't seem to grasp that just because a distribution seems to be using a lot of the same tool as another distribution, oh, well, then they must be the same. No, like I said, a car has four wheels and four doors that don't make every car the same. I hope this clarifies it a little bit. Because it drives me up the wall and now I really want a shower. Anyway, there's a lot of misconceptions in Linux, like a lot of misinformation about Linux in the community. And there are only one group of people that are at fault of that, and that's us Linux YouTubers. We are not doing a good enough job of giving you guys and girls the right information. If it's because Linux YouTubers don't like doing research, or if it's because the popular Linux YouTubers is based on drama and not facts, I have no idea. But we apparently are not doing a good enough job of educating you guys and girls. So it's our fault that you don't know this. So therefore, ask questions and do research. See you all later. Bye.